Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're here in the town of Dor Kiredon, full of dwarves that are stranded here on the moon. And this is a tavern or inn of sorts. It's an outside museum. Under a stylized beer mug is written Gemstone Inn, which they named after the town of Gemstone to try to make the place, try to make people more at home. Obviously they missed their home. So I'm hoping we can get them and us off this moon at some point. That would be good. The only thing is, so there's two ways in. I don't know why my voice is so shaky like that. This, I think we came in through the, like, staff entrance. This is the actual main entrance here. So it's really late or early. I couldn't find where to stay. Unless... unless we just find a bed and lay down. Can we talk to her? A pretty dwarf lady smiles at you. Welcome, travelers. If you need the rest, you can rent first-class rooms at Gemstone Inn. Please register over there at reception. Define over there. Oh, okay. Welcome. What brings you to my fine inn? Sleep. Sleep brings us. Your stay will cost 90 gold pieces. Agreed? Yes. Now the only problem is, it's already 2. I want to rest here so we can get out. Is this the well-built dwarf? You know, well, so wait, where were we that we get? There's the kitchen. We went. We didn't go... wait. It was here. Okay. Actually... I'm just gonna... anyway, it's already 5:05. Does time pass differently because we're on the moon? Just very quickly. Very quick. Okay, so now if we sleep, we'll sleep till morning. Until dawn. The time is going very fast. Look at that, 7:10 already. It must be shorter days here on the moon. That's pretty cool, actually. Yeah, it's so fast. Like, it's literally been an hour. But not really an hour as we think of it. I'm just trying to find the way out. Now, we shouldn't get tired quicker. That wouldn't make sense. Unless it's like a jet lag kind of thing. Really just want to move on and explore some more here. Okay, so what's this? Is this out? I'll be able to return. Kira's dwelling. Okay. Let's meet the man himself. It's an annoying song. This is the elf song. Are you Kire? A serious-looking dwarf and voluminous clothes speaks to you. Welcome to Kire's residence. Kire is in the throne room from 9 a.m. to 9:30 p.m. Then he bows and whispers. In confidence, I do not know how he can bear it there the whole time. My brother Orin thinks he may not be quite right in the head anymore. Please don't tell anyone. Okay, so he's in the throne room now, wherever the hell that is. Hello? The stubby dwarf guard says, "Do not provoke Kire. He is often in a bad mood." A strong dwarf is on guard here. He growls. We are not allowed to speak. What, you just spoke that. You violated the law. Ahead of you is a hall in which the splendor of the old dwarf kingdom appears to be blossoming again. The polished stone flags of the floor glitter in many colors, and splendid columns and wall coverings decorate the room, in the center of which stands an imposing throne. Very colorful. Hello? A red-bearded dwarf looks at you from under his helmet. He is wearing a brightly colored ceremonial uniform. Is that Kire, or shouldn't he be on the throne? Hello, that's Kire. As I see, you accepted my invitation. He's a 240-year-old dwarf warrior, level 14. Hopefully you have not been delayed. The thought of spending the rest of your life here should not make you doubt anything. But tell me what has happened on Lyramion all these years. Citrine and the others tell of the happenings and adventures on the islands of Lyramion. Kire listens to everything with great interest and then says in a hoarse voice, "If only Dorina could experience this with us." Okay, so we can talk to him about Dorina, I'm sure, yeah. And then, hello, he does not respond to that. No one has any manners anymore. What about Dorina? She is the real reason why I wanted to speak to you. But first, I must point out that this is a private matter. I must demand the strictest discretion. No one may hear of this conversation. Dorina is my wife. 10 years ago, she disappeared under strange circumstances, but I have found evidence that she is still alive. She has been seen in the forest behind the swamps to the south of Dor Grestin, that village covered in weeds. Okay. That we couldn't find on the map, supposedly northwest of here. I would like you to find her and give her this message. If you are successful, I will reward you highly. With these words, Kire hands you a sealed envelope. Your careful questions about the circumstances of Dorina's disappearance are answered by only a silent shake of his head. Kire's letter. Alright. We have it. What is to be said has already been said. Find her and give her the message. Let's see if I answer any other questions about Braun. Has to be sometimes something that's not highlighted. Dor Grestin? I'm surprised he won't say anything else about Dor Grestin. He said it's covered in weeds. Maybe it's not seen easily on the map because of that. You know anything special about yourself? About a mage? Or magic? Or magic words? Or a mine? You have a problem? Problems. You know, Snizhim. You know, Tempest Fugit. No trouble. Okay. Farewell. Now I'm gonna save. Because I wanna see if we can read this note. I bet you it won't be seen highly if we read it. Why he's so secretive about it. But if we can read it, we can restore. We have the magic spell restore. Oh, Kire's note and Kire's letter. Do we? We've read one of them, right? Oh, I think I did. Didn't I get this from before we knew who these people were? Now we know who they are, so we have context. Bron, my brave warrior. I'll read it again. I think I found this in the tower, the dungeon. Temple of the Brotherhood. Bron, my brave warrior, let me give you an important job. Scout around our new world to watch for one of those airships. If possible, get on board one of those ships and try to get help on Lyramion. Perhaps with your assistance, we will succeed in getting away from this dreadful forest. I was able to put... You notice he said forest, not moon. I was able to put one of these navigation stones to one side. It is hidden in the old dwarf mine. You need 8 different stones to clear your way into the treasure chambers of the dwarf mine. Topaz, ruby, emerald, earthstone, blah, 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 amber gem, good luck. Kire. Okay, so this... This item cannot be used here. Okay, we can't use it. So it don't matter. Welcome. I hope you can comply with my little requests. Your little request. Haha. Now we rule this moon. I like these different banners or tapestries. Whatever they might be. Well, it's a very big room with not much in it. There's another room here. Just want to look around a little bit more. Okay, we can duck in there. Hello? A coarse-looking dwarf with weedy eyes stares at you intently. Probably not supposed to be in here. You do not speak the same Okay, who speaks dwarf? I think Nelvin might? No. Oh no! None of us speak... Oh, wait. Yeah, Nelvin does. Why didn't I not see that? Okay. Nelvin speaks. You can talk to him. You don't run away. Storgat? Greetings, travelers. My name is Storgat. I am the head of the digging mine at the test mine of Dor Kiredon. Okay, now we can ask about mine. Almost 15 years ago, when it seemed fairly certain we could survive, we began to examine the underground parts of the moon. The results were disappointing. No metals, just a few minerals, some pretty colored rack formations, which you can now see as the flooring of the throne room, and often a few lumps of useless amber. But the mine is closed at the moment. Key of the mine? Only Kire is authorized to issue the keys. You can ask him for them, but I hardly think he will give you them, especially now that these Tornak beasts are getting into the mine. Tornak beasts? Can we ask about Tornak? Yeah. The Tornaks are beasts. Makes sense, since they're called Tornak beasts. Like almost all the local kinds of animals, they are fearful opponents. And a short time ago, so many of them got into the mines that they were forced to withdraw. And now, of all times, I am thinking about asking the advice of someone from Dor Grestin, but Kire refuses to consider it. Yeah, you guys are stuck on this mine, you don't even get along. That's sad. Sad state of affairs. Well, let's ask about... see if I ask about anything else about Brog. Dor Grestin. Dor Kiredon. That's what it's called, right? I don't know what we're talking about. Oh no, isn't it? It's, Dor Kiredon. Well, now he knows what we're talking about, but he doesn't know anything special. It shows up like that now. Donner? Dorina? Hello? Journey. I was wondering if we can hear more about their journey here. Mage. Magic. Magic words. Problem. Problems. Schism. Tempest Fugit. Trouble. Well, I'm out of things to ask. Thing. Farewell, travelers! They look like skulls. They might be. Wow. Big long table. Reminds me of the table. Yeah, we can sit in each chair and get up. Reminds me of the table at Sovngarde. And the Elder Scrolls 5. Alright, we've got people here. Can we get into there from here? We can. Okay. I missed, like, a lot of times I don't... this barrel is just full of beer. A lot of times I don't notice these doors. They don't exactly stand out, some of them. I always think these are, like, potions. Hello? Can I look at either of them? No. You see a middle-aged dwarf lady. From her clothing, it appears she is the head cook of the residence. She says, "Welcome, noble travelers. Please forgive my haste, but I have much to do." With these words, she turns away. Hmm. An ancient dwarf is mumbling to himself. He says, "What an awful fate to end my days on this compost heap of a world." I would like to rescue them all from this fate. This is where we came in. It's like a bathtub, sauna, hot tubs, kind of. Ah! I'm going number two. Look in there. I don't think we'd like what we would see. So, which is the men's, which is the women's room? Get me out. Alright, we're gonna check around these chests or crates, whatever. It looks like awesome chests. There's nothing in them. It's heartbreaking. of flavor text around here. Alright, so that's the way out. There's these two rooms on either side. Oh, I think this is the way we came in. So, wait. If that's not the way we came in, then what's at the end here? Right, because I hear those two dwarves guarding the place. Oh no, this doesn't lead out. Well, this is back to the Sovngarde dining hall. Back here, but this isn't... Right, that's the way in. This is a side way. It's late already. Time flies when you're on the compost heap of a world. We did speak with you, right? Yeah, you're the one who said that. Alright, so that's not the way we came in. We have to go through the kitchen. Down the Sovngarde hall. That's the... Okay, this is a bunch of fires. So this is not stairs. So many interesting things to look at, but no response from anything. Okay. Is this where I was looking at all this stuff, or these other... No, I'm not sure I looked at these. I might have. Be thorough here. I don't want to sleep! Alright. So how do I... get back to the main hall? Without leaving. Because we did get over here without leaving. Oh, through the hall here. That's right. Alright, let's... Are there any more doors coming off of here? Been in here, have we? Have we? It's a very long room. I gotta check all this stuff. What if one of them has something in it, right? Is that? Get to the eye. It like skips through it. I know there's a way to do it too, I just forgot. Full of beer? No description. These least they could tell us it's full of beer, and they're not even telling us that anymore. So that's the way we came in. Alright, I think we're done in here. Can I talk to you? Really just gonna wait around a little bit. Well, I'll explore first. Before you know it, the sun's gonna be up. Just filling out the map. The sign says, test mine Dor Kiredon. Okay, this is what we need a key for. A threatening humming sound is heard, and you are suddenly attacked by huge insects. Really? Here in town? Curse-Wasp? Alright, I hope they don't actually curse us. I wonder how tough these things would be. Thunderbolt for a row of monsters. Cannot penetrate, cast a lame spell. Deflected. It deflected the thunderbolt. Wow. One of us lame here? I am. Well, Sabine has a cure for that. Remove lameness from me. Wait. Did that work right? Does it just remove for everybody? So I can remove lameness. It immediately changed her spell. It doesn't want to target. Okay. This removes it for the whole party. Alright, so Thunderbolt didn't work. Let's try... Is it Fireball? Fireballs for one monster. I could try Whirlwind, it's not really effective, there's only two monsters. I'm gonna throw a waterfall. Wind Howler. Wind Devil? Okay, they're all single target. Oh, I notice. Oh, look at that! Wrong world for Mudsling, Rockfall, Earthslide, Earthquake. Can't use it at all. Wrong world. That's so funny how it says that. Alright, so I'm gonna throw a fireball at this one. You are incapable. Alright, I need to be healed by lameness. cast for everybody. Oh god. She's been turned googly-eyed. Ouch. Boom. Did that do something? I missed it. I didn't see anything saying it failed. Alright, so she is... driven mad. Alright. Do we have anything that can cure that? What does the bitter do again? Ooh, didn't ask for a target. Okay, well I can attack again. He's not going to use bitter. Revitalizing flask? I don't think that heals madness. Which party member will be... Oh, it doesn't say. Oh wait, no, I didn't mean to hit okay. Curse-Wasp was cause disease. We gotta kill these things. This is crazy. I didn't mean to forward the next battle. The next round. I don't see anything on him obvious, so I'm gonna throw another fireball. I wonder what the swamp lily does. If I know, I've forgotten. I don't know if we have anything. I don't think we have anything that has a charge of Cure Madness on it. It would be cool. Counter Herb. Oh, I hit it again. I'm meaning to like cancel out or something. I must be thinking of another game. Oh my god, 44 points of damage. Oh, it did do damage, 52 on him. Keep throwing those fireballs. We got rid of one. So just getting near the mine is a problem. Retreating. Would I hit fire beam instead? Will not allow you to retreat. Literally, the only one who could go is Selena. She's the only one who can act before the Curse Wasp leave. Reminds me of F. Paul Wilson's Secret History of the World books, and Repairman Jack, and Adversary Cycle books, which are all linked together in some way. They have these nasty, like, human-sized wasps, I think they are, called Chew Wasps. These are Curse Wasps. I'm not even going to bother choosing anyone else. I'm just going to have Selena take it the rest of the way down. 6 damage, nice. It's got to be somewhat close to death. It moves 2 squares at that. Things fast. Wasps are nasty things, I'll tell you that much. Nice. Only 5 experience points? Huh. That's lame. Speaking of lame, well, she's not lame, she went insane. Let's get the heck out of here. We don't have a return point for that one. Oh, more insects! I'm not sure how much more of this we can take.